4 years ago, I stood in this spot and told you why Stockport deserved to be a Portas Pilot town. Now, 4 years later, I can stand in the same spot and proudly share with you how we've managed to use that investment to drive forward a creative vision for the town, which we hope will be built on for years to come. This is the story of local people coming together to help point their town in a new direction. This is the story of local businesses, local residents, and the local community. This is the story of Stockport Old Town. The group's first major decision was to create a new visual identity for the area, and so the Stockport Old Town brand was born. We wanted it to be simple, bold and effective and show people how we're creating a contemporary destination to visit, which is full of award-winning independent businesses.
The branding's really, really good, sort of something modern, doesn't look dead corporate, it looks interesting.
The whole brand itself, which is a fantastic idea, creating a brand for Stockport, especially the Old Town area, is key to driving its success, I think.
The marketing and the branding behind the Old Town, it's just colourful. And you see it on billboards and banners and posters, and it makes you want to go and have a look at what's going on there.
Well, I think the branding's strong. I think it's really good. I think I remember chatting to you about kind of where you're going with that design, and I think you got it right, because it's just... It stands on its own 2 feet, that.
I think the brand was absolutely brilliant because it was something that was bang on trend. It was unique and it stood out, so whenever you saw it, you knew it was Old Town branding. It was great to see a great big billboard on the A6 with all the cars passing promoting it. But I also loved the maps as a handout so that people actually got a sense of identity. They could have a look at it. What is this Old Town?
Probably once a day, somebody comes in looking for directions, and the map was brilliant to sort of go, you know, go along High Street, go over the bridge, go up the hill, go down the step, you know, and just get people oriented and where they were going.
I think the branding's very strong. I like the, there's the town centre map that you could sort of follow the trail and stuff so you knew where everything was. And I think, yeah, it's one of those things that you can turn to. You can just go and look at it online, see what's coming up.
The importance of Stockport having its own identity and something unique and different that will draw tourists in is really, really important. Previously, there was nowhere to go online and look up what is happening this weekend. Stockport needed a unique brand. And, you know, the Stockport Old Town branding was really, really important. And we're on a level where we could potentially compete with the Northern Quarter in Manchester. It's that kind of feel about it.
Now, one of the major plans for the Portas Pilot in Stockport was to create a multifunctional art space right in the heart of Stockport Old Town, where all sorts of creative activity could take place. Now, getting a project like that off the ground is by no means an easy feat. In fact, I actually had to leave university in order to focus all my attention on trying to open the space. Now, since we've opened, we've had some tremendous success in getting lots of people back to Stockport Old Town, especially in the evening. We've run all sorts of events from poetry nights, quiz nights, comedy nights, and incredibly popular folk nights. So I think 7 miles out is really important because it's brought people to the heart of their town centre in the evening to socialise and have fun.
Seven Miles Out, I mean, it's a really funky place. It looks brilliant. It's very, very friendly. It feels family safe and all of that. It's very welcoming. You know, there's some really good, particularly young performers performing here. And I think it's the sort of place that gives opportunities for young local people and old local people, let's be fair.
I think 7 Miles Out is a great place to come, just socialise, meet new people. It's a really nice community space. And it's just a really brilliant place to perform because it gives you a chance to perform to a whole different audience. And I think in Stockport especially, there aren't really many places like it.
I believe 7 Miles Out as a venue, it plays a big part in bringing like arts and music and general, you know, all sorts of like entertainment to like the community here because they need it. And I tell all the people in Manchester where I go on the Northern Quarter, I say, you know what, if you want a piece of Northern Quarter in Stockport, come to 7 Miles Out because it's like that in microcosm. It's
Stockport Old Town, there's a great sense of community now, which I never knew existed. All the events that are on and the hard work that goes into it, all the festivals, folk festivals, they're just brilliant for the area, and I can't thank the people behind them enough for what they've done to the area.
The events and festivals have been very, very successful. And most of them are being held outside, and touch wood, the weather has been very kind. And then you've always got 7 miles out here to fall back on and come in and have a cup of tea and a cake. And you just feel very welcome when you come here. It really is. It's the place to be. It's definitely the place to be.
I was tasked with trying to find events that we could sponsor. This concept of a Fringe Festival was raised. You know, we just thought it was perfect. We were like, this is brilliant. This is something different that the town isn't doing already. I mean, we've sponsored 2 festivals so far, so this year will be our 3rd. And it's something that we want to continue with, you know, in the future.
Now, if you come to the marketplace on a day like today when the market is shut, you don't really get a sense of the kind of change you've been able to make with our investment. In order to do that, you need to come to the marketplace on the last Friday of every month from 6 till 9, where you'll find the whole place transformed by street food and drink and the hundreds of people that come to Foodie Friday.
Foodie Friday is brilliant. It just brings so many people together. It's amazing how busy it gets. It does feel like a community.
I think what's fantastic about Foodie Friday, you go down and it's all lovely people. You know, you sat there and you're having a drink and you're getting some food and everyone's so friendly and talking. I mean, it's just a fantastic night.
When you get this, all these families coming together for the events that we've been putting on, and it's absolutely heaving in marketplace and all having a really good time, and that's what we're able to do.
Events such as Foodie Friday, consistently amazing. Just my biggest night of the month. It's nice for that buzz to be happening. So we've got us here now, we've been doing our thing for nearly 2 years. We've got Remedy Bar open across the road. So there's a circuit going on, there's a, you know, a bit of life happening.
I think Foodie Friday is absolutely superb. We've tried to do it here with getting colleagues down, you know, on a Friday in the summer, go straight up from work, and there are a lot of people. Last year, I think a group of about 20 of us went down. For quite a few of them, it's the first time they've been to it, and they're absolutely blown away by the whole event.
As well as Foodie Friday, the Portas Group has also funded a number of other projects which have had a big impact on the Old Town. The launch of 20th Century Stores created a permanent hub of vintage traders, which has built on the success of the monthly award-winning Vintage Village. Stockport Market received funding for events and to purchase new gazebos, which has improved the delivery of outdoor activity like the Teenage Market. The Medieval Viking Festival animated the marketplace with longboats, medieval market stalls, and a Viking village in the grounds of St Mary's Church. The Artism Gallery was set up to support artists on the autistic spectrum and gave local artists a unique space to exhibit their work. The Stockport Old Town pop-up shop gave local young makers and design graduates a retail space to showcase and sell their own products. And our innovative shopfront project helped promote investment into the Old Town by addressing empty units with 3D graphics. One of the most important questions we now have to ask ourselves is, what happens next? You know, where do we go from here? Well, having seen the impact that our investment has made in the marketplace, we now need to turn our attentions to revitalising the underbanks so the area can really live up to its true potential.
I found in the year that I've been here that there's been more shops coming into the area. So we are managing to get rid of those to let signs. I think what is bringing people here is that they're seeing the success of Stockport Old Town and they're seeing that investment and how that has worked. But I think we're just waiting now to see that filter down and see how further investment can support this part of the Old Town and really, help this area thrive and keep it going.
Working with the Portas Pilot team, which has been absolutely focused on the Old Town, developing the brand of the Old Town, bringing forward activity and the animation of the Old Town is absolutely critical to us going forward. We've committed considerable capital sums to invest in the physical fabric, but also we know that we need to work with local businesses and local interests to make certain that the place is animated, that it's used. And the work that's been done by the council and by the Portas Pilot taking that work forward on things like Foodie Friday and the vintage offer just proves beyond doubt that if the quality of offer in the town centre, in the Old Town, is right, people will come.
This project was all about piloting new ideas, and if we're given the time and a budget in order to build on some of our best work, then I'm positive that we can make Stockport Old Town a thriving destination for generations to come. I live my day, I live towards the last, live my day.